Hey everybody, it's Dr. Jo, and today I'm going to show you my top 7 knee strengthening exercises. So let's get started.
Disclaimer alert.
If you happen to have some knee pain, especially when you're doing strengthening exercises, you can use a knee sleeve. The folks at Titan Compression sent me some of their knee sleeves, and if you're interested in purchasing them, you can click up here. When you use any kind of knee sleeve, you want to make sure it fits right, because if it's too tight, you're going to cut off circulation, and if it's too big, it's going to kind of slide around. So with the compression sleeves, it's not a brace. It doesn't stabilize your knee. What I like about the knee sleeves is it's kind of like a hug. It just kind of holds everything together a little bit. It gives you some compression to keep the circulation going, and it does give you that little bit of feel of security. But if you have something like an actual ligament injury, this is not going to stabilize your knee. But if you have arthritis or something like that, this is going to really help just kind of keep everything together with that nice hug. So the first exercise is going to be what we call a short arc quad. So basically you're making a short arc. I like using a foam roll, but if you don't have a foam roll, you don't have to use a foam roll. You can take a big beach towel and roll it up. You can use a ball like a basketball or a soccer ball. You just want it to be something where you have a short little angle there on your knee. You want to keep your knee on the roll the whole time, so you're not picking up your leg. You are just straightening your leg at that knee. So you can either sit up like I'm gonna do, or you can lie down. You wanna be comfortable. So if you're kind of uncomfortable sitting up like this, make sure you lie down. So all you're gonna do, keeping the knee on the roll, is just straightening it up as much as you can. See how I kind of pull my toes up at the end? That just kind of helps activate all those muscles. I'm strengthening that quad muscle right there. That's the one that extends or straightens our knee. So do a nice, slow, controlled movement even when you come back down, and get that little squeeze at the end there. So if you have knee pain or an injury and you're trying to strengthen it, you might not be able to get that knee fully straightened, but that's okay. Just try and go as far as you can. Big squeeze at the end. You should feel that muscle working, and nice and slow going back down. I would just start off with 10. If you get to 10, that's easy. You can kind of slowly work up. If you're getting to 20, 25, and it's easy and it's not very hard, you can add an ankle weight around your foot just to start strengthening it a little bit more. So the next one is going to be bridging. Bridging's one of my favorites because it not only works the hamstrings, it works the glutes, and all of this has to do with strengthening your knees as well. So go ahead and lie all the way down. Get nice and comfortable and prop your knees up. So what you want to do is, as you come up, kind of come one segment at a time with your back. So you're not just popping up and then popping back down. You're really controlling this movement. So you're just bringing your booty up off of the floor. So coming up like this, you want to just get pretty straight. You don't want to try and arch it up there. Just nice and straight, little pause at the top, and then slowly come back down. So not fast, making sure that those muscles are doing the movements, not momentum doing the movement by just dropping you back down. So same kind of thing. I would just start off with maybe 10 of these. If that becomes easy, and if you get to 20, 25, then you can try doing it just with one leg of a bridge. But if you feel like you're kind of dropping that hip down, then you're not ready for that single leg bridge yet. So make sure that you're doing the correct technique the whole time. So then the third one is still doing a bridge, but this time you're gonna use a resistive band with it. And so what this does is it helps activate other muscles while you're doing the movement. So you wanna take the band and put it around just above your knees at your thighs. So start off with a really light band. If it's different brands, usually the colors are a different amount of resistances. So I would start off with the lightest one, whichever one you have. So same kind of thing, you're gonna go into that bridge position, getting your knees bent. But as you can see, that band's trying to pull my knees inwards. I wanna try and keep them as straight as possible. So I'm not pulling out necessarily, I'm just holding them in that bridging position without letting my knees come in. So holding it there, and then you're gonna go back into that bridge position. You might be able to see my legs might be just wiggling a little bit, and that just means that those muscles are working. So now I'm activating these outer muscles as well as the glutes and the hamstrings with the bridge. So again, with this, I would just start off with 10. It might feel kind of easy, but you're doing more work with your body than you think you are. So just slowly progress up from there. And then if that gets pretty easy, you can go to a higher resistor band. So then we're still gonna do bridges, but now we're gonna just go in the opposite direction. So using a ball of some sort, it can be a basketball, a soccer ball. If you don't have anything like that, you can fold up a pillow and put it in between. You can use a yoga block. You want it usually to be something kind of soft, but you want it to be enough where you can squeeze your knees inward. So now you're activating those inner thigh muscles. So same kind of concept. You're doing that bridge, you're doing that controlled motion, but this time I'm squeezing in when I'm lifting. So a lot of times people kind of forget to squeeze in. So make sure you're squeezing in first and then lifting up into the bridge and then nice and slow coming back down. So if you feel like you're coming out a little bit, then just reset everything, squeeze in, come up, nice and slow back down. So sometimes the muscles want to cramp underneath those hamstring muscles. So if you feel that, just come back down. You might not be quite ready for that yet. So now we're going to go into a seated position. So the fifth exercise is gonna now be a long arc quad. So we did the short arc quad on the floor. Now it's just gonna be a longer arc. So that's why it's called the long arc quad. You wanna sit in a chair, get nice and comfortable. If you need to relax in the backrest, you can, because you don't wanna be hunched over. You wanna be nice and upright. And then all you're gonna do is just straighten out that leg. So again, you're squeezing that quad muscle. You're contracting it. Pulling up your toes at the end helps, but you don't have to. And then just nice and slow coming back down. So don't just drop that leg back down. The coming down is just as important, if not more important, than the coming up. So nice and controlled, little squeeze at the end, nice and controlled coming back down. So even though this might not feel like a lot, if you're trying to strengthen those muscles because you're injured or you haven't been doing exercise in a while, this is gonna be a lot. So again, make sure you're doing it correctly. If you get to 20, 25 and it's easy, you can put a small ankle weight around your foot just to give you some more resistance. But don't go too much with the ankle weights because that open position is gonna put a lot of stress on the knee. So maybe 3 to 5 pounds of ankle weight at the most. So the last ones are going to be standing up. So this one is just a squat. Squats are great. They kind of work everything around the legs and the hips. So they're really good to do, but you want to make sure that you're doing them correctly. With squats, you want to keep your knees behind your toes. So if you feel like you're going forward like this, then you're putting a lot of pressure on your knees, and then that's going to be really painful. So you want to stick your bottom back. You want to kind of even yourself out. Keep your back straight, but bend at your hips. You want to have even weight on your feet, so not back on your heels, not up on your toes. I like using a chair behind me, not necessarily that I'm sitting down, but if you're a little weak because you're trying to strengthen it, you go down and you can't get back up, you can just sit down in the chair. So feet about shoulder width apart, toes pointing forward, not out, not in, nice and forward, and then coming down, sticking that booty back, and coming back up. So you're really trying to find the chair with your booty. But if you don't have the chair, that's fine. You don't have to touch it, but make sure those knees stay behind the toes. So you can just go this way. You don't have to go down that deep. If you're just starting the strengthening exercise, you can do what we call a mini squat. So you're just going like this, but still keeping those knees behind the toes. You're not doing this with my back straight up like this. You're keeping the back straight, but you're hinging at the hips. So you're going down and then coming back up. So same thing, just start off with 10. If you get to 25 and 30, it's easy. You can start adding some weights up here if you want to, or you can start with like a one leg squat. But the last exercise is still gonna be a squat, but this time you're gonna use the band again to activate those other muscles. So I'm just gonna put it again, kind of right above the knees, around the thighs. Get that about shoulder width, maybe slightly past it for this so you can kind of get that band resistance, and then do the same thing. You want to make sure those knees aren't collapsing inwards. You don't want them going in like that. You want to keep them out and still have that good form with when you squat. So you can go down deeper as long as you keep that good form, or you can just do a little mini squat with it. But if you feel like your knees are collapsing in like that, then you're probably not quite ready for that band. So there you have it. Those were my top 7 knee strengthening exercises. If you're interested in purchasing the Titan Compression Knee Sleeve, make sure and click on the link up here. And don't forget to subscribe by clicking down here. And remember, be safe, keep those knees happy, have fun, and I hope you feel better soon.